Can I develop my .NET MAUI apps with Visual Studio Code is a question that I get asked all the time. And the answer is no. But something might have changed, so let's check out this video and explore what our options are for using .NET MAUI with VS Code. Because .NET MAUI is now a first-class citizen in the .NET ecosystem, it's integrated also fully inside of all the command line tooling, so you can do .NET new MAUI, and you can do .NET publish for your MAUI apps, and that means you can also use it from VS Code, right? So you can open the files, obviously, because it's just a text editor. You can do all the things there, and then with the command line, you can do your builds and check if everything is okay. It was also announced with the introduction of .NET MAUI that the best experience, for now at least, will live in like full Visual Studio, so Visual Studio on Windows, Visual Studio for Mac, and that will be the tools that has like the full integration with all the emulators and all kind of setup for that, and the hard reload and all that kind of stuff, right? So if you want to have the best experience, you have to go to the full Visual Studio, which is available for free. So, you know, you can still get started with .NET MAUI entirely for free, but there is a lot of fans out there for Visual Studio Code, and for good reason, because it's a wonderful product. So how cool would it be if you could also do .NET MAUI development inside of Visual Studio Code? And now you can. So let's hop over to my machine and let's see what this is all about. Now, if you've been following my channel for a while now, and if you haven't, then maybe you want to subscribe to my channel for all kinds of wonderful .NET and .NET MAUI content. Then you notice that I'm doing this on a Mac. I've been on Windows for a little while, but I decided to demo this on a Mac for just no other reason than I have my Mac in front of me right now. But everything that you see here also works on Windows, you know, with the exception of seeing the iOS simulator here. I don't think this extension will connect with your Mac. You know, that's one of those things that definitely works in full Visual Studio, but not in this extension yet. Maybe it will come, I don't know. But here you can see Visual Studio Code already open on the left, and I already have this extension installed. So I'm talking about .NET Meteor, which is kind of like a wink, a nudge to Comet, which is our solution for .NET MAUI MVU, right? And they also have a extension that also already allows you to run .NET MAUI applications through VS Code, but it's a little bit more tailored to it using Comet and MVU. I have a video on that as well. It should pop up on your screen right now. I think this is actually a fork, and now they're kind of like, you know, developing from there specifically for .NET MAUI apps. This is done by Nikita Romanov, so thank you so much for doing this. Already 1500 downloads, very good ratings. You can see I zoomed in this window here a little bit, very good ratings. So a lot is going on here. And what it has right now is you can do all kinds of .NET 7, .NET 6 apps debugging, including WinUI, MAUI, native C Sharp, Android, iOS, Mac Catalyst, and deploy them to devices and emulators. So that's kind of like the core of this extension. It's fast and responsive. It does not require you to install the OmniSharp VS Code extension separately. So something is built in for this. I don't know exactly how that works. It shows all your projects, and it works on Windows, Mac, and Linux. So you can also do this on Linux. I haven't tested it. It has been tested on Ubuntu. Let me know if you want me to test this for you, and let me know down in the comments, and let's see if we can, how far we can take .NET MAUI development on Linux. How cool would that be? Let me know if that's something that's of interest to you. Then run the application. I'm going to show you this in a little bit, but this is all stuff. So there's a little bit of an important thing down here with the limitations. Hot reload is not available, but they're working on it. So that would be ultimate, right? That hot reload would be in here as well. An example IntelliSense is not available. At the time of recording this, I've already seen a PR on the repository for this extension. It's all open source. You can contribute if you want. And I saw there is already a PR that adds the XAML IntelliSense as well. So that is really amazing. Now, I've already installed this. So it's just a matter of going to the extensions pane right here in Visual Studio Code. It's this couple of blocks right here. Search for .NET Meteor, click the install button, and you should be ready to go in seconds. Then what I'm going to do is bring up a little terminal. I'm going to press control backtick here. You also have an option in the menu, so make sure that you get a terminal or open a separate terminal that's not integrated in VS Code that works as well. I'm going to create a directory, so make dir. Well, actually, no, I'm not going to create a directory. .NET new can do that for me, so I'm going to do .NET new MAUI, and then I'm going to say -n VS Code test. So this is going to create a new MAUI project and it's going to name it vscode test. And because I do the dash n, which is the dash name, it's also going to create a subfolder in the current folder that I'm in. So now I can go into change directory vscode test, and that folder should be there. And now what I can do is open that with code dot, and did you know that you can do dash r? So it will reload it in the current window. So if I do that, it's going to reload the current Visual Studio Code window instead of opening a new one. Now, you've learned at least one thing in this video. So now you can see the contents of this new project, which is just a file new .NET MAUI application. You can see some things are building here already. But the really cool stuff is here, not these warnings here, so I'm going to close those, is here down at the very bottom in this status bar. So you can already see we have the debug and the release. So this is coming from our .NET Meteor. I can select if I want to run a debug or a release build. And here you can already see Android accelerated Oreo. So I don't know, what does that do? Let's click it. And you can see it's fetching devices. It's going to go out to my Android SDK. It's going to go out to my iOS Xcode installation. And it's going to list all these devices right here that I have installed. So again, the full Visual Studio experience will install all this stuff for you, or it will at least tell you like, hey, it's there, it's not there. This is now, if you want to use this, your responsibility to have this installed, the Android SDK, all the prerequisites. But if you have that, then you can see that I have all this stuff. I can just select my macOS, my MacBook right here, and it will start running the Mac Catalyst one. Or I can select all the iPhone ones. And because this is just the VS Code interface, I can just start filtering like this, iPhone 14. And this is the one that I have open. You can also see the icon is a little bit different. It actually sees that it's running right here. So I could just select that one. Now there's one more thing I need to do before actually running this. So let's go over to this run menu, the debug pane right here, run and debug. And whenever you do and you don't have a launch.json yet, it will give you like these options. And you can here click create a launch.json file. Now, if you don't know what that is, this will create a .vs code folder inside of your project. We'll see that in a little bit, which has a launch.json file. And that's kind of like the definition for VS Code so that it knows what commands to run to actually start a debugging session for all kinds of projects, right? So we're going to do it for a .NET MAUI app right now, but you can also do .NET 5 Plus and .NET Core, Blazor WebAssembly, Node.js, all kinds of things, right? But if you have installed the .NET Meteor, you can also see now the .NET Meteor debugger. So if I click that, is going to create this new launch definition, which has a bunch of stuff. I'm not going to go into the specifics here. Again, if you want to learn more about this, maybe I can consider doing some more VS Code content. Let me know down in the comments below. But this is all that's needed for a .NET Meteor build, basically. So this is saved automatically. And if we go back to the files right here, you can now see that I have this .VS Code folder with a launch.json. You can commit that to your Git repository, and everyone in your team can now benefit from this. Just open it in Visual Studio Code and you can run it from this. Now go back to our run and build menu right here. So this screen has changed. I now have this play button right here. You can select other launch.json options whenever you have them, but we don't have them right now. So I can just click this run button and it's actually going to, you know, to run. So you can see here, it spawns a new terminal. You can see the commands that it's doing, .NET build with like all the options that are needed to actually come up with the debug that we've configured here down at the bottom, the simulator that we selected here down at the bottom. It's going to restore all these things. And whenever it's done, it's going to actually launch it here on this simulator that you can see here on the right. So you can see the build finished, debugger is ready and listening. So I'm expecting the .NET MAUI app to come up on my iOS machine right here. There we are, it's going to launch, and we have a fully functioning .NET MAUI application now running on the iOS simulator. Now, I already mentioned that the XAML IntelliSense is not there, hot reload is not there, so that's a couple of things that if you've been working with full Visual Studio, things that you cannot do right now, but all the other things you can just debug through here. You can set breakpoints as well, so I can go into my main page, I can set a breakpoint here in my on counter clicked, and whenever I do, you see that it breaks. I can step through it. I can do all these things. I can just press continue. I can actually, you know, I can change some code here. I get full IntelliSense for the code at least. So I'll get this button. I can set the text color, do set app theme color. You can see this is really the .NET MAUI APIs right here. So I have all that. And the IntelliSense, for example, and hot reload is apparently coming. But at least this will give you the basics and you know, be able to debug and run your .NET MAUI applications from Visual Studio Code. Now, already said, you can also definitely select the Android one right here. So the Android emulator, it will work all the same. You can do all the stuff on Windows as well. So .NET MAUI for Visual Studio Code, this is how to do it. Now, while this is very early days, you can do the basics already, right? And it worked brilliantly. I just installed the extension. I selected my simulator, created a new project, but it will also work on an existing project. I actually tried it on the .NET MAUI Community Toolkit project sample, which is in no way prepared to run on VS Code or any of that. So I just plugged in that launch.json on that repository, started the application, and boom, it ran on iOS. Now, truth be told, I had some issues running it on Android, both for macOS and on Windows. I reported those issues on the repository, so hopefully those will be fixed soon. I'm not sure if they're very specific to me because, you know, my setup development machine is kind of a mess. So maybe I just have some weird SDK installation going on and it works perfectly fine for you. Let me know down in the comments what your experience is. But I have high hopes for this, that new features will be added. And I mean, you can already start with this today, right? You can start debugging, you can start running, selecting your emulator on VS Code. And to be honest, I'm very curious if this will also work on Linux, like is promised. So again, let me know in the comments if that's something that you want to see as well. But even if you don't let me know in the comments, I might just make that video just for me because I'm very curious to find out now. Thank you again so much for watching one of my videos. Please click that like button so that all the people can learn about VS Code and .NET MAUI so that even more people can now get started with cross-platform development with .NET MAUI, which would be really amazing. Subscribe to my channel if you've liked this video and you want to see more. And hold on, don't go anywhere yet. Check out this playlist right now for more .NET MAUI content. This video is recommended by, you know, the how the moon stands and the stars are just for you today. And I'll be seeing you for my next video.